Okay. Hi to everybody here. Hola, buenos días, buenas tardes. Estoy aquí junto a una amiga, una educadora que es de California, que conozco hace mucho tiempo y es una persona que quiero que ustedes conozcan también. La entrevista va a ser en inglés, sin embargo, hay mucho material que ustedes pueden entender de esto. Hi, Katy, welcome here.
Hey, nice to see you.
I'm so glad to get back in touch. It's been years.
It's been years.
So, what's your work? I know you're doing a lot of stuff. Tell us about who you are.
My name is Kathy Katz, and I'm an educator of effective communication strategies, and I'm a transactional analysis practitioner. What does this mean? I teach people how to communicate rationally and not emotionally, because feelings are not negotiable. So I have many books and I've been doing this for over 10 years. And the reason I do this is because I personally have received better results. So when people aren't communicating effectively, they're not getting results. They're breaking up with boyfriends. They don't even know the reason why. So they ask me questions. It's mostly about romance, but the information is universal. You can use it in your with your coworkers, with your family, with your romantic partners. It's even with the people that live next door to you. And it's a way to love yourself more than other people. A lot of us have been raised to please other people first. So I teach people, I give them permission to love themselves first and other people second. And it's really difficult. And usually I tell people it takes about four times to talk to Kathy. My website is talktokathy.com. And on there, I have a blog. And I also had a podcast years ago. And the best news is I was a career woman. And now I'm a woman with a career. And if you don't know the difference between that, a woman with a career is someone who has family first, relationship second. A career woman is all about making money, about having a job. So I've learned to balance. I teach people to balance their feminine energy and their masculine energy.
And
Go
Kathy,
ahead.
there are many women, especially here in South America, who have no idea that what's the difference about being feminine? Is it just like you have makeup and then you're feminine? Or what do you mean by feminine? What's masculine?
Okay, basically, what I teach is scientifically accurate, politically incorrect. Our brain has two sides. The left side of our brain is the logic side. It's the do-good, it's the masculine, it's the performance, compete, conquer, control. Usually, we use this side to work. As women, we are born with the feeling side. Everyone's born, I don't know, in utero, everyone is a female. So everyone has a masculine and feminine side. It's knowing when to use it. The feminine side is knowing how to be receptive, how to be vulnerable, share your feelings. I've worked with so many women. They do not know how to share their feelings. They don't even know the feeling. They say, I feel like. Like is not a feeling. I teach them to say, I feel sad. I feel disappointed. I feel excited. So I help them understand that it's okay to be masculine at work. But when you're in a romantic relationship, which has the priority? The masculine, do good to feel good, or the feminine, feel good to do good? A woman has to feel good to do good. A man, masculine energy, has to do good to feel good. If he has a terrible day at work and he comes home and he's yelling and screaming, ooh, we know to keep our mouth shut. That's being feminine. And that's a hard one. A lot of women want to be the masculine when they come home. They want to talk. And the man only has 5,000 words a day. By the time he comes home, it's almost used up. Women, oh, I'm sorry, I said that backwards. Women have 5,000 words a day. Men have about 3,000. So their words when they come home are almost gone. So I teach women to keep their mouth shut unless they have to call a doctor, a lawyer, or a police.
So let's talk about who teach you all these things, and let's talk about
Oh,
wonderful Dr. Pat Allen.
my Dr. Pat Allen, who just turned 86 years
Oh my
old
God,
last,
happy
I think it
birthday,
was last
Dr.
week.
Pat.
I've known Dr. Pat for almost 40 years. And when I met her, I had moved here from Chicago, Illinois to California. My father had died suddenly. I was 23 years old. And the father is very important to the little girl. Well, I was 23, but my parents were divorced when I was 14. So what happened, someone said, Kathy, you have to go hear Dr. Pat Allen. She's a wonderful teacher. You need to start dating, you know, you need to get out. So after he died, I went to see her and she was amazing. And she's written so many books. And that's what I do with my groups. My classes, I teach them about staying married and loving it. A lot of people want to get married, but they don't want to stay married. And her first book is Getting to I Do, which is the Bible. And it's not just about getting married. You could live with someone, but she talks about, do you want to be a free wife? So you learn all kinds of little good habits and techniques and strategies in her book, Getting to I Do. It's a wonderful book. So many people buy it. They give it to their girlfriends and then they want it back and the girlfriend, she lost it. So it's about books. She's taught me so much. And transactional analysis, I actually got certified through her. And that's the work of Dr. Eric Byrne. So if you wanted to know more about that, I teach that as well.
And Kathy, how did all, you will have a lot of couples who get together, they don't know each other, they're like a few months and they decide to either have a baby or by accident they have a baby or they get married. And then they find out after a few months, this guy is not the way I thought he was, this girl is not what my mom told me to find. And why do we rush? Why is that?
Okay, well, first of all, remember I was talking about daddy? Yeah. What happens with a lot of women, when they marry, if they didn't have a father, or daddy died, or daddy was an alcoholic, or daddy went to military, they did not have the umbrella. Daddy's our protector. So what they do is they get into a relationship. This is the majority of the people that I work with. They get into a relationship, and they look at their mate to be their daddy. He's not their daddy, he's their husband. When you get in a relationship, you marry the relationship. You do your part as being the one you want to be cherished, and you hope to God he does the one of the masculine, where he's the provider, he's the giver, he's the protector. What happens is women want to be like men so much. You know, she says there's more women with penises and more men with vaginas than ever before. And so it's about balance and knowing who you are. The better you know who you are, are you the masculine at work? Are you the feminine at home? The better you'll relate with other people. So that's the most important thing. So when you're at home, what happens if you bring your masculine home and your husband's masculine, you'll always fight. And you'll use the language, I want this. And he says, I want that. It's not going to work. And Dr. Pack's language in want training, she talks about a woman shares her feelings. I feel sad. What do you think about making dinner tonight? I'm not comfortable cooking. So it's a communication system that's so effective, so effective. And I, by the way, didn't get married till I was 40 years old. So, and I miss the baby making years, and it's okay. It's really okay.
But I guess that it takes a lot of courage because you have to work on yourself. You have to make this emotional contract that Dr. Pat talks about. And we don't know that. And I guess that also, not only that we look for that, but sometimes we want to find a baby and we make them a baby and then we do everything for them and we become the mamas. That Dr. Pat Allen also talks about that figure, right?
He could become the daddy figure if he didn't have the right mama. Most important parent to boys is their mother because it's their first love affair. Mm-hmm. And little girls, it's the daddy is the first love affair. Little boys, it's the mommy, the first love affair. You know, she says we either marry or mate with somebody 51% like daddy or not like daddy. It's very, very interesting.
And I think that that's where you can explain a little about chemistry, right? Dr. Pat says that it has to look a little bit like mom, but not so much. Or how does that work?
Okay, first of all, when two people meet, I tell them, if you want to be the feminine, you cannot talk first. He has to talk first. You can be the masculine, but you'll attract a very feminine man who wants you to pay for everything, the groceries, the house, the vacations. Okay, so make sure, again, you know who you are. It's so important because you're giving the man mixed messages. So know who you are, which position, and then you use the language that corresponds with the energy. I don't know. Did I answer that question?
Yeah. But the whole thing is, how do we select? What if we are?
Oh, chemistry. Chemistry. Yeah. Yes. Okay. So chemistry is that eye-to-eye communication. That is something that I do not teach. Chemistry is the DNA. It's the universe. You could be at church with someone and have chemistry, and they're married. Right? It's that. Now, women, once the man talks first, if you choose to be the feminine, women get turned on to what we hear. Men get turned on to what they see. But a lot of women are picking with their eyeballs instead of listening. So don't let his magic wand get in your body until you negotiate a deal. And that's what I help women do. Learn how to negotiate, not intimidate with fear and not seduce with guilt.
Right. And seducing with guilt, it's one very, very common game, right?
Well, I think a lot of us have been raised in cultures. I'm Italian, and I know as a little girl that guilt, you know, either the Catholic guilt or the Italian guilt, you know, we had the guilt. But I help people work through that, because what transactional analysis tells us is those are games. People play games, but they're unconscious. They're not conscious when they're playing a game. So I help them be more aware. And how? Being good listeners. Listen for the deal that you want, you know? So a lot of women, it's basically learning patience. And you know how I teach women to learn patience?
How?
Buy an orchid plant and wait for it to grow. Because a lot of women are very impatient. It takes an orchid a long time to grow. I personally have killed a lot of my orchids.
And what's the first step for a guy who's listening to this interview to know if he's in his masculine or his feminine? For guys, how do you find that out?
Okay, a masculine energy man is very giving. That means he initiates. He sends the text messages. He buys the flowers. He buys the cup of coffee. Okay, he's chasing her. The sperm chases the egg. The egg, the feminine, sits. We wait. We wait patiently.
But what's the problem with women that can't wait and they think that that's old-fashioned, that you don't do that anymore because now we are equal and we have to compete and there is no way a guy has to conquer. I can also conquer. Well, you know, that's what happens.
You know what? That is a wonderful question. And what eventually happen is they could stay together until somebody dies or goes crazy, but it's not what we call a complementary relationship. I don't know how many of your listeners or viewers know what a waltz, when you dance with somebody. Yeah. Yeah. I teach waltzing, not slam dancing and not discoing. Waltzing, you go back and you go forth in the relationship. It's not all one way. It's back and forth. You know the yin and yang? Men have yang bodies and yin souls. Women have yin bodies and yang souls. But what happens is a lot of women have been raised to be masculine because daddy wasn't around. That's one of the big issues that I hear a lot of. Daddy wasn't there. So I teach them, I give them permission to love themselves. Take bubble baths, go for a walk in the park, get in touch with that feminine side. Stop the controlling, the competing. Do you know, my husband tells me often, he says, you know, Kathy, I think women are more competitive than men. Guys seem to have a good relationship with guys, but women with women, I'm sure you've heard and seen them. They're very competitive.
Yeah.
And that's a game, you know. Well, my daughter went to this college. Where did your daughter go? That's called the game of one-upsmanship. Well, my boyfriend drives a fancy car. What kind of car does your boyfriend drive? See? And here's another thing that women don't understand. Women get what they want by knowing what they don't want. There won't be any surprises if you're clear. I don't want a man who doesn't have a job. I don't want a man who doesn't want to have children. I had a couple one day. They were married about 2 years. And the reason she came to me is because she wanted to know how to work with her husband. She goes, Kathy, how do you do it? I worked with my husband for 17 years. like our desks are 4 feet apart. She couldn't do it. She hated it. And he said to her he would give her babies. And long story short, he didn't have integrity. He didn't mean what he said. And it came out in one of our sessions. They ended up divorcing and he remarried. He did not, he said he wanted, men, you've got to mean what you say and say what you mean. And women too, women do it to men as well. So we take a risk. We know what the prize is and what the price tag for dating someone. What is the prize? This man, are you compatible with him? Now you have the chemistry. Are you compatible? Do you have the same wants and not wants? Do you really want children? Do you want to work? Do you want to stay at home? And then finally, it's communication. And that's my specialty. I teach people how to communicate more effectively, to ask for what they want and say no to what they don't.
But for communication to work, I think that one has to make a commitment with oneself. It's not that if my partner doesn't want, then it doesn't work, right? Because the blaming game, I think it's something that happens.
Absolutely. And I teach people how to stop the blame game. And it's through Dr. Pat Allen's tool, The Stroke and Stand. It's in her book, Getting to I Do. We have three permissions in life. And we were taught this in transactional analysis. You have a right to be who you are. If you like the opera, or you like bathing naked, or you want to have 8 kids, you have a right to be who you are. You have a right to your own thoughts and ideas. You have a right to your own feelings. So when somebody doesn't agree with you and you have an argument, this tool will help you get through the argument in a respectful or cherishing way, not a discounting way. I do not support discounting other people because you do have a right. You either accept people that they're 51% good, nobody's 100. 51%. Dr. Pat Allen stayed with her husband because she loved his Persian rugs. What's your 51%? What's, you know, every one of us is different. I have people say to me, Kathy, what would you do? What would you do? And I say, I appreciate you ask what I do, but I'm not you. At the ultimate thing is to be true to yourself. What do you want and not want? By the way, men get what they want if they're masculine by going after it. They want that woman. They want that car. They want that house. They want that job. So know what it is. That's the most challenging part.
I think that goes with the hunting nature, right? The masculine hunting, the sperm going to find the egg. It's not the egg going behind the sperm.
Yes, but I have a lot of women that want to be the egg and the sperm. And you know what? That's narcissism. And narcissism is okay if you're single.
Right.
If you're married, it doesn't work unless somebody's the 10 and somebody's the 0.
Right.
Want to be a doormat? You have every right to be a doormat, then don't complain. I have women come to me and they'll say, oh, Kathy, I'm tired of paying for the dinners and I'm tired of paying for the vacations. And I said, wait a minute, you picked him. You picked him. So now I teach them, and this couple actually ended up getting married. It was wonderful because I work with them and they learned how to negotiate, because it's all about negotiate and renegotiate. It's not about intimidate people. After all I've done for you, now you won't have children with me, you know, and then seduce. I don't teach people seduce, you know, seduce, intimidate with fear, seduce with guilt. So know what it is you want.
Kathy, can you talk a little bit about what Dr. Pat Allen defines as free girlfriends or free wives?
Oh, free wives, yes. Ah, yes. I had a couple the other day, and she's going to move in with her boyfriend. And I said, don't you want the ring? The ring is status. You can be a free wife. There's no problem there. But be true to yourself. Don't mind read. Don't think the guy's going to wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning and I'm going to go buy her a diamond ring. It doesn't happen that way. Women require it. We don't demand it. We don't do ultimatums. So if you want to live with the guy and you want to clean his house and you're happy with that, you know, there's a lot of older people doing that right now. The grandparents, which isn't setting a good, in my personal opinion, which doesn't mean much. They're not setting an example, but what's happening is our laws and our legal system, they'll lose their pension. They'll lose his pension. So they move in together. So what do you tell the little children that come in your house? There's so much work to be done. It's an ongoing thing, but they have a right to move in with someone without a ring, but a ring is status. And it's saying that someone else knows that you're in a committed relationship. And what's a committed relationship? It's someone that you have a long-term exclusivity, continuity, you have the same goals. And Dr. Pat says, know someone for an entire year, spring, summer, winter, fall. You know, what if you did get married to someone in 3 months and you discovered at Christmas time he did not like Christmas trees? And you're like getting the house ready and he's like, what are you doing? So just something as simple as that. Now, my husband isn't Catholic. He's Jewish. We come from two different religious backgrounds. So we negotiated. He comes to church with me 2 times a year and I go to his synagogue with him whenever I want. We acquiesce. We do it for the team. Nobody's right. Nobody's wrong. I don't believe in it unless it's immoral, unethical, or illegal. Go along.
What's your advice for people who are questioning their lives, their financial status, where they have to pay for everything? I do have a lot of students and clients who come and tell me, but I have to pay for him because he has to have this big, huge name and he doesn't work. I do the... Why do we do that as women? And still, like, you have grown-up kids and you're still paying for their... And you never teach them independence. Why is that?
Well, first of all, you want to be an I before you can be a we, before you can be an us. That's another set of books that I can tell you about. It's He, She, and We by Robert Johnson. You know, what happens is it's called our life script. Do you remember the life script? Yes.
There's a whole workshop on the life script, right?
Wonderful, wonderful. As little girls, our mothers are our role models. If we saw mama take care of daddy, pay for everything, we learn that from her. So it's not that it's bad or inappropriate, but what happens is people get in there and you know how they could tell that it's not working? They don't feel good. Ladies, you better follow your feelings. And what happens when women don't follow their feelings? They get sick, they get distressed, and they get disease. Again, where did you learn these behaviors that you're gonna pay for this man's house? And if you're okay with it, I've worked with doctors, lawyers, I mean, it doesn't matter. If you're not communicating and negotiating good deals for yourself, it's really what it's all about. You have a right to say no, but what's the prize and the price tag? Will you lose your hot guy in bed? Like, I have a woman, she's with this guy because he's so good in bed, but she's the breadwinner. He's the feminine, she's the masculine. And she just realized it the other day. She's divorced with 2 grown kids in college. Goes, oh my gosh, Kathy, I just realized I'm so masculine. She has her own company, but he's good in bed. So which relationship do you want? Do you want the covenant, the convenient, which is 50-50? I don't have a problem. Or the codependent, and it works both sides. You know, there are 18% of men that are homemakers right now and the woman is out working. There's nothing wrong with that. It's what you negotiate. Does that help?
Yes, and it's also how you feel, right? It's like the example that Dr. Pat gives about Madonna. And you can be with you know, you can become a cougar if you want, but you have to know what you're doing.
Yes, there's a lot of cougars out there, and that's fine. There's cougars, yeah. So know where you're going. Stay in your lane, because what happens is they come to me because they get mixed messages. Kathy, she said she didn't want kids before we got married. Now she wants to get kids. Kathy, he drinks so much. I'll say, well, didn't he drink before you married him? Did you think he... See, women think they're going to change men after marriage, and men are praying that women don't change their hair color. They don't change. It's very interesting.
How do you fix a relationship that is really not working at all and they are 20 years together and they can't just go by themselves because they have no money? What would be the first thing that they can do?
Okay, first of all, I ask people when they come in, are we doing an autopsy or a resuscitation? You understand the difference between those words?
In Spanish, it's autopsia or resucitar.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. Where are we going here? Okay. So remember, again, it goes 51% good. I know women that are married 37 years and their husband is making a lot of money. They haven't had sex in I can't tell you how many years, probably since the second son went to college. Okay. And they stay because of the money. The three human behaviors are money, sex, and mind-altering chemicals. So you're saying, how do they get out of it? Or what do you say?
What do they do? Because there are couples that are just used to pain, you know, to staying together.
You know, like, what? In the book, there's the relationship contract. It's right. In Dr. Pat Allen's book. You negotiate time, space, money, and play, sexual and non-sexual. Because when you get married, everything. That's why I like people to come to me before they get married, to make the contract before you get married. And then you review it every 4 months. And then after that, once a year. So what if your husband loses his job? Now you have to go back to the contract. Who's paying? How are we going to do this? Oh, I'm a hairdresser. I'm going to have to go back to work. Okay. So what about your house? Now you can't afford the house payments. Well, you know what? Do you get another job or do you sell the house? And you know, sometimes that's where people like you and I help people, because when you're so close to it, you don't see it. Yeah. So when you come into someone who's a facilitator, you know, a mediator, you can see the picture better. And you help people use the words, the language to help themselves. But if some people want to get out, they're at empathy and apathy. They've had it up to here. They've been paying the mortgage and they're not getting any sex. Those are the two things. When women divorce, it's from the neck down. When men divorce, it's from the neck up. They want to stop paying and women want to stop having sex. Sorry, it's that simple.
Yeah, and I think that the first indicator for this is the lack of attraction, right? Intimacy goes down because you're like partners, but not a couple, because you're just competing or you're just trying to stay together but not like each other.
And during this pandemic, too much proximity ruins intimacy. So, you know, some people live in a one-bedroom apartment. What do you do? How do you separate your space? But it's worked. I teach people how to help themselves do better and help women feel better. And the communication, again, there's a tool. When a woman is uncomfortable, it's really important that she shares her feelings, because men think everything is great if you don't open your mouth, but I teach you to open your mouth respectfully.
Right. The more a man is, permission, right?
Yes. The more a man is respected, the more he feels cherished and he will cherish you. The more feminine energy women are cherished, the more we feel respected. Remember the brain, we have both sides. And there's a wonderful book. It's by Barbara and Alan Pease, and it's called Why Men Don't Listen and Women Can't Read Maps. It's really good.
Yeah,
it's good. Yeah.
But one thing that is also very funny is the respectful part, because it's like a woman comes and says, how can I respect this? The name.
You know what? Remind her that she picked him.
Right.
She picked him. And does she want to get laid more than paid or paid more than laid? Or does she want equal? Because, you know, everybody doesn't have to be married. You don't have to be married. Pat Allen talks about it all the time. You marry the relationship. You don't marry the person. You do your part as the feminine, and you hope to God he does his part as the masculine.
Yeah, that's true. And there are many, many small things that we have to learn, but I think it's the applying part, right? While we're doing our one day-to-day lives, while we are able to talk, and this thing of talking, one talks, you know, think, and the other one talks, feel. And that's the big fight. The two things or two feels doesn't work.
And you know what? This is when we're little. By the time we're 3 years old, this is science. You know who the bullies are. You know who the whiners are. And you know who the negotiators are. If you didn't learn it, this is Freud's work. If you didn't learn it by then, you're an adult. And, you know, change is it's a sense of growing if you're willing to grow, but we can't make people change, but we can change the way we speak to people with our language or nonverbal communication. Nonverbal communication is 90% of all communication. Cell phones, texting, email, tones of voice, body language, gestures, right? And there's tools in the Getting to I Do book that help you get through those situations as well. Does that help?
It helps a lot. Thank you so much. I'm really grateful for having this talk, and I hope to see you again. And it was wonderful meeting you again. It's It's been years, and I wish Dr. Pat Allen keeps working. She's so wonderful.
And I'm so happy that you're sharing the message, because it's really our responsibility to share this message with everyone who wants it. We cannot coach people that don't want to be coached. Remember that. Yeah. They have the right to not be coached. And please do check out my talktokathy.com. It's Kathy with a C. And I know you're in a different time zone, but I do my Monday night Zoom class at 7 California time if anyone's interested. Thank you.
Yes, send me the link and I'll share it, and we'll see each other soon.
It was my honor. Thank you so much. And I wish everyone a happy, healthy life.
Bye-bye. Thank you for giving us your wisdom. I think that's the most important thing here. You know, there are many things going on outside, but inside we can do something about that. And thank you so much, Kelly.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
See you.